Hello, this is John Schaap and welcome to this video in the updated 2021 version of the AirGroup 8 video series. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use and configure AirGroup. AirGroup is an enterprise class solution for Bonjour, DLNA and SSDP services. AirGroup provides context-based awareness for services across networks and is supported in both tunnel and decrypt tunnel forwarding modes. AirGroup supports both wired and wireless devices and can employ ClearPass Policy Manager for device registration and policy sharing. Network is still the same as in all the other videos, so we're going to reuse all the work that we have done already in the other videos for this AirGroup configuration. From an end user's perspective, it's a very easy way of mirroring or printing or sharing information from one device to another device. But this solution was developed for home use and not in enterprise use. So in home use, you normally have a single layer 2 domain and then this all works fine. But in enterprise, those domains are cut up in different L3 domains, and then you need a solution like AirGroup to provide these services over the different VLANs. So both mDNS port 5353 and SSDP port 1900 are used for discovery. So this is a discovery packet from a client. And then you have the DNS response packet from the server that's announcing all the services that the servers can provide. So AirGroup supports the following pre-configured service. That is AirPlay, AirPrint, Amazon TV, Dial, DLNA Media, DLNA Print, Googlecast, iTunes, Remote Management and Sharing. The modes of operation are either centralized mode or distributed mode. So centralized mode is when you have a mobility conductor and you run the process on the mobility conductor. In distributed mode, you run it on all the different controllers in your network. So these are the prerequisites to enable AirGroup. You have to configure OpenFlow, bind user VLANs, enable OpenFlow in the user role and virtual AP. And all these three things are enabled by default, so you don't have to do anything, just check that it's done. You have to configure a management server profile, enable deep packet inspection, and enable firewall visibility. And I'm going to show you after this slide how you are going to check all these details if that's set up correctly. So we're logging into the Mobility Conductor and we highlight Mobility Conductor and then we go to Controller Profile, OpenFlow Controller, and check that the OFC state is checked. That's on by default. Then we go to the Managed Network to our cluster of controllers. We go to Profile and we go to Controller Profile, OpenFlow Profile, and check that Master IP is there with that port number and that the state is active. And again, this is all set by default, and also that all the VLANs are configured, 1 to 4094. So I didn't change anything here, this is just checking that everything is set correctly. So I installed this as AOS 8900 by default, and then you have all these things configured by default. If you check your roles and you go to more, you can also see that OpenFlow is enabled there, so you have to have that enabled on all your roles. But again, this is by default enabled. Then we go to System Profiles and then the Wireless LAN, and we go to the Virtual AP Profiles. And here also check under Advanced if OpenFlow is enabled, and that should be enabled by default. Then go to Controller Profile Management Config and check your default controller profile that AirGroup info is checked. And also this is just for verification, you do not need to configure that, this should be on by default. And then we go to Services Firewall, and we already did this in a previous video, but these two you have to enable if you don't have done the previous videos. So enable firewall visibility and enable deep packet inspection. So now we come to the configuration of AirGroup, and these are the things that we have to do. So first go to the command line interface, and check what your path is. So I have to go to MM, go to Configure Terminal, and set the AirGroup version. AirGroup version by default is version 1, and I want to use version 2. So this can only be done in the command line interface. And now it's set for version 2, and that's the most recent version of AirGroup, so that's why I use that. If you then do show AirGroup status, you see that the AirGroup version is version 2. So that is good. Then we are going to go to Manage Network, System, Profiles, and that's where you will find AirGroup. Expand it, and that's where you will find AirGroup Profiles. That's the default profile, and we are going to create our own profile. Give the profile a name, so I'm going to call it Cluster Profile. And that's where you can do allow or disallow VLAN. You can allow or disallow roles, and you can do the auto association. And you can also do the enforce registration. That's for later when we are going to introduce ClearPass in the picture. Right now we're not going to use ClearPass. It's AirGroup alone on the controllers. So we now have created a AirGroup profile, as you can see. You can expand that again. And what we need to do here is add a service profile. So you can add multiples, so you can do AirPlay, I do AirPrint. So all the services that I want to use, I'm going to select here. So only select the ones that you need. If you do allow all, which is also possible, depending on the network size, of course, that can create a lot of stress for the controllers, because if there's a lot of AirGroup servers and clients on the network, it will increase the number of packets big time. So that's done. The other place where you find AirGroup is under services. There's an AirGroup tab there. That's where you enable or disable it. And that's also where you select what mode to use, centralized or distributed. Select the previous configured profile. And for the rest, you don't need anything here right now. What you will see here is a warning that you selected distributed mode and it's not recommended with a mobility conductor. So please use centralized mode, then you don't see that warning that you see down here. So that's done. Don't forget the pending changes, of course, and deploy. So AirGroup is now running. And then we can go to the dashboard. Services, and you will see your AirGroup services and your AirGroup clients. If you see what service they are providing, if it's AirPlay or anything else, you can list it here. You can see if it's DLNA, if it's AirPlay or anything else, what these servers provide, in which VLAN they are. And these are the clients, so there's 4 clients right now. Go to the command line interface to further check what is going on. So first we're going to check the directory, because it's very important where you issue these commands. You cannot do that in /mm. You have to go to the directory where you configured AirGroup. That's what I just did here. So this is still the view from the mobility conductor. And that's where I issue the AirGroup commands, because it's running in centralized mode. So if you do show AirGroup status, you see that it's running version 2, centralized, and that the cluster profile that we previously configured is attached. And that's also mDNS and DLNA are enabled, and what services are enabled for AirGroup. So this gives you a good overview of how AirGroup is doing. And then we're going to do show AirGroup switches, and those shows you all 3 mobility controllers that report back to this mobility conductor. So show AirGroup servers shows you which servers are there if they are wired or wireless, and what type they are, if it's mDNS, DLNA based. And same thing for the other side is the users. So show AirGroup users, shows you your AirGroup users. And as you can see here, if they are wireless, you see a username, an AP name, an AP group. You don't have that for the wired connections, of course. Show AirGroup cache shows you all the services that are in the cache. So these are all services that are provided by my AirGroup servers. It's a long list. And then we are going to see show AirGroup threat statistics. So it gives you server count, user count, and all kinds of packets that are going back and forth. So it's very good to see how AirGroup is doing. And then show AirGroup service shows you the configured services and the service description. So you have here AirPlay, AirPrint, Dial, the ones that we have configured in the profile. You will see them back here and if they are used or not. So go back to the graphical user interface, and that's what we can configure under AirGroup. So ClearPass, which we will do later. AirGroup domain is for distributed environment. IPv6 is for V6, of course. Profile we've seen, services we have seen. And here under services, you see the default services, but if you want to create your own, you give it a name, service description, and then you have to add the service ID. Now, how do you get the service ID? You go back to the command line interface and you do show AirGroup blocked service IDs. So these are service IDs that clients are querying for, but they are blocked. So it can be a query or a response, but they can both be blocked. So if you want to copy them, you copy it, go back to the CLI and click OK. You can copy as many as you need. So you copy them here. And in this example, I just do two, but as I said, it can be more. You deploy, and then you go back to your AirGroup service. You see that it is configured, and you can go now to your AirGroup profile, expand it, go to AirGroup service, and now select from the list the one that you just created. Call my service profile. So now AirGroup will also work for these services that were previously blocked. Other things that you can configure under the AirGroup profile is disallow VLAN. So the VLANs that you do not want to participate in this process, add them here and say which services should be disallowed and they do not participate then. The same goes for roles. So if you have roles where you do not want to use this, you can add them here. And then we have auto associate. So you can select the service again, and they then do auto-associate on AP name, AP group, or AP FQDN. In the command line interface, you can see what this AP name will do. So if you do show AirGroup APs, you see the APs and the neighbors and the name of the APs of the neighbors. So a server on one neighbor can reach, or a client on one neighbor can reach a server on another neighbor AP when you use AP name. So here you see the radio A neighbors and the BG neighbors of AP535. So now it's time to bring ClearPass into the picture, and this is a device registration page of a AirGroup server, and you can see that you have all these shared with items here. So you have shared with a user, shared locations, shared roles, shared groups, and time sharing. So time sharing is based on time. And this is the same thing, but this is from the access tracker. And this is what is being sent back to the controller. So you see shared group, shared role, shared users. So how do we configure this? We go to AirGroup again, and now we go to AirGroup ClearPass. I already added this server, so you can see it's called CPPM. These are the default values. Keep in mind that this runs on a different RFC 3576 port, so don't change that. Also add your RFC 3576 server. That was the same as from previous videos. And the server group is also from the previous videos. So here we just add ClearPass as a server to AirGroup. And then you go to your AirGroup profile, the one that we have been using up till now. And now we're going to modify this here, and we say AirGroup server enforced registration. That means that whenever a server registers, it goes to ClearPass to see what shared information it needs to download. You go to also add the AirGroup ClearPass profile that we previously configured in here, and that is it. Then you go back to AirGroup just to check that registration is enforced, registration is enabled, and that also the right ClearPass server group and RFC 3576 server is selected. If we then go to ClearPass, you see that there is an AirGroup authorization service by default and a device registration disconnect service by default there. You do not have to add them, you do not need to modify them. Just check that they are enabled, that they have a green LED at the end, and that is it. What you do need to add is the mobility conductor, because that is where those RFC 3576 requests go to. You have to add it with these details. So IP address, the shared secret, and do not change this to 5999. Leave the port default, but keep the vendor on Aruba. So that's the mobility conductor added. Then we go to ClearPass guest. And that's where you have to add the mobility conductor and one of the managed devices. So I've already added them here both. You can see that these use port 5999. And if you see more details, it's just a name. Enable the AirGroup notification, the host name, leave the port default, shared secret, tell it how to log in to the controller or to the mobility conductor. And the same for the controller, but a different IP address, of course. And then once you've done that, then you can select them and say read configuration. It's now reading all the configuration items from the controller or for mobility conductor, depending on which one you do it on. And then if you go to show details, you see that it has all the details, so it now knows all the roles that are configured there, the AP groups that are configured there, and also the AP database. And the same goes for the controller. So on the controller, there are more roles, so that's why I also added the controller, because those roles are not configured at the mobility conductor. And then you go to AirGroup configuration. You leave everything default here. And here you can select which shared options group names you want to have available. So if you want to add more, you just type them in here, and then they are later available for selection. And for the rest, everything stays default. Click Save Changes. And we're done. Now we're going to add the devices. So I already have added two devices. And if you want to add the device, you have to give it the MAC address. Give it the name, enable AirGroup, very important. And then you have two choices, personal or shared. If you select personal, then you can just share it with different users. So that is when, for example, at a university, you give students access to register their devices, and they can share it then with other users. But you cannot use any of the other shared options. They come available if you click shared, and now you have to share it with. So you can say which user to share it again with, but you can now also select the locations. So it can be AP groups or named APs. You have shared roles, so you have the whole list, because you have just read that from the controllers. And you have the shared groups. And that's also a list where you can select from. And time sharing, if you go to syntax, it shows you how to set that up. I'm not going to show you that further, how to do that. Create. And then you have created a new AirGroup server that will query when it connects to the network. It will query ClearPass and to download all the shared information. So go back to the CLI, check that you are in the right directory, and then you can do show AirGroup status. You now see that the CPPM profile is CPPM, and also that enforced registration is enabled. That's the difference between what we've seen in the beginning of the video and now. Now we are using ClearPass. Show AirGroup CPPM server group shows you the server group that it's configured and that it is in service, so that's correct. Then show AirGroup CPPM server radius statistics to see if radius is communicating correctly. So we see requests and accepts. So that's all looking good. There's no bad authentications, no unknown response, so everything's fine. The same for RFC 3576 statistics. And we see 3 COA requests and 3 COA accepts. So that is also looking perfect. Then show AirGroup users. So we now see the users, and you see that the wireless users have role, group, username, AP name, AP group, and the wired do not, because that's not available for wired, of course. That's only for wireless clients connecting to the access points. And then the other one is show AirGroup servers. Shows you all the servers, and also if they have, you can see the CPPM stats. If there's no policy, it means there's no entry in the ClearPass. And if it's done, then it has downloaded the information from ClearPass, the shared information. So most of them have no policy. I just have a few servers in ClearPass. And then if you issue the command show AirGroup CPPM entries, that's where you can see the CPPM entries that have downloaded information from ClearPass. So you see all the shared information that I've configured there. So there's no AP group users in this case. I just have shared groups and shared roles configured. So now have a look at the access tracker of ClearPass, what is happening. So here you see a web auth, and that's a device registration disconnect. That happens when you add a new device to ClearPass, or if you update a device on ClearPass. And that then, if that device is connected, it will disconnect the device and let it connect again. And then you can see all the shared information that you have configured is sent to the mobility conductor. These are all authorization services. So here you see a little bit more things configured. Shared group, shared role are configured here. And this is a normal Wi-Fi client connecting, but now we send back one more thing, and that's the Aruba user group. So this group is also configured on the server, and it's now shared with this user via the group. That brings us to the end of this video, so let's recap what we have done. AirGroup is an enterprise solution to use Bonjour, DLNA and SSDP services, which normally only work over a single layer 2 domain and not in a large enterprise multi-VLAN environment. With AirGroup, you can control which services are allowed and also who can access these services. Extending the AirGroup solution also with ClearPass device registration gives you complete control of who can share what and with whom by configuring shared attributes. Please like, subscribe, and let me know what you think in the comments. Bye for now.